I'm sure all of you understand that over the past 20 years, excavation damage has been one of the leading causes of serious incidents on pipelines, especially involving gas distribution systems. More recently, from the years 2008 to 2010, excavation damage has cost about 22% of all serious hazardous materials liquid pipeline accidents and 18% of natural gas transmission pipeline incidents. For natural gas distribution, pipeline excavation damage caused about 20% of those significant incidents during that two-year time period. But because of the efforts of this organization and you sitting in this room, there's been a significant reduction in the number of incidents related to excavation damage. We have seen a significant drop from 22% in 2004 to 13% in 2010. Yet, excavation-related incidents remains the third leading cause of significant threats to the pipeline safety infrastructure. In the past 12 months, there were a number of high-profile excavation-related incidents that resulted in fatalities and injuries. In 2010 alone, 5 fatalities, 13 injuries, over $20 million in property damage resulted because of excavation-related incidents. For example, a 36-inch natural gas line in June in Johnson County, Texas, is a good example of the work we still need to do. One person lost their life and 7 others were injured at this pipeline construction project. This incident is just one of the many reminders that we, together, have much work to do. We must continue to promote pipeline safety, and this is a key reason why PHMSA strongly supports this conference and what you folks do. Through the continued steady leadership, PHMSA continues to support national and state damage prevention efforts through grants, recommended practices, awareness, and regulations. On the advocacy side, many states have damage prevention laws on the books that have significantly strengthened damage prevention programs in those states. We'll continue to work with those states and urge them to adopt effective enforcement aspects of these laws. Many states are making great progress to implement the 9 elements of an effective damage prevention program, which include communication, stakeholder partnership, improved underground location, employee training, public education, conflict resolution, enforcement, technology, and data analysis. The continued use of exemptions by states in their own one-call laws is still an area of concern for us, and I know many of you. In order for these one-call laws to work, everybody needs to be playing by the same rules. Exempting certain stakeholders simply weakens the chain of the one-call system. And I can tell you from a local government person, when I saw that our public utility folks are out there digging, replacing water mains, and not having those roads marked or those areas marked, created concern, not only for the public, but for the emergency responders and the workers themselves who are working on those job sites. So that's something we all need to work on to try to get rid of those exemptions. We challenge the state and local stakeholders to get involved and recognize when potential legislative changes are being proposed in your states. PHMSA can work with the stakeholders, with you folks, to emphasize the need for a positive change. On the grant side, PHMSA has been providing grants to for damage prevention since 2008. And since that time, over $4 million in state damage prevention grants to 30 states and one-call programs to help them assist with the implementation of the 9 areas that we mentioned earlier. I encourage damage prevention stakeholders from different states to share your best practices with others so that others can learn from your successes. On the awareness side, our inspectors, along with our state partners, are looking at the effectiveness of the pipeline operator public awareness programs. Are they really getting the job done out there? Public awareness and education and damage prevention need to be connected so that people who work and live in the pipeline rights of way understand what those systems are so that they can operate safely. They need to have the information in order to prevent these incidents from happening. The results of these evaluations will be used to help us refine our program so that measurable public awareness programs can be improved. We'll also ensure that public awareness programs include provisions to outreach to those public safety access points, the PSAPs. Those are the 911 centers. In fact, I was talking to Rick from Virginia last night. about how we can engage some of this PSAP initiatives. I'm glad that our fire marshal from Minnesota is part of the board, because we can help make those connections with those public safety access points. We've worked with a number of stakeholder organizations to develop recommended practices under PIPA, which is the Pipelines and Informed Planning Alliance. And of course, as you know, this particular initiative helps local governments better understand and make better decisions in terms of developing their land in and around pipeline systems. As the San Bruno incident indicates, when that pipeline was installed back in 1956, that area was just wide open rural area, and since then a lot of development has encroached over top of that system, and we see the result of the aging infrastructure when it occurs beneath a residential community. That PIPA report is going to be key to helping local governments understand how can they better develop and understand that redeveloping property near and around pipeline and other utilities has to be considered. That report's available on the stakeholder website, and we're going to be spending a lot of time with our PIPA communications team to develop and implement outreach and education strategies and long-term initiatives to keep that report up to speed and current. On the regulatory front, PHMSA is also taking next steps to implement federal enforcement of third-party excavation damage to pipelines. We're developing a rulemaking that will take action against third-party excavators who unlawfully damage underground pipelines during excavation activities. Third-party excavators are those who are not employees or contractors of the pipeline operators. The Pipes Act gives PHMSA some limited backstop authority to conduct civil enforcement against third-party excavators if the state has failed to do so effectively. As I wrap up, I just want to underscore that preventing excavation damage is a shared responsibility and requires full engagement by all stakeholders, the industry, government, and others. Some stakeholders are only partially engaged, and we challenge everyone to step up to the plate. We owe it to the people who have suffered injury or death out there because of pipeline incidents, and we need to do it to prevent these things from happening in the future. As I mentioned earlier, April is right around the corner, and PHMSA is gearing up for National Safe Digging Month. As the Secretary indicated, he's going to deliver a keynote message to the ConExpo in Las Vegas later this month, and I can assure you that he is fully engaged in this issue. He alluded to that in his opening remarks, but as Steve and others will tell you, Secretary LaHood wants to solve this problem, and he wants to get the right people around the table. Many of you who are part of the AGA and other industry organizations have heard the Secretary speak to you, and believe me, he wants to get this done, and we're committed to working with you to make that happen. I hope you'll lend your support to the National Safe Digging Month program in April and promote and educate the new audiences that we need to reach on how to call 811 before digging. We all have a role to play in reducing excavation damage. You guys are making a difference out there in reducing damage, and we thank you from the Secretary, from Ms. Quarterman on down, for your dedication and commitment to this effort. I want to assure you that DOT and PHMSA will continue to work with you, standing side by side to encourage you to share how and where we can help improve damage prevention initiatives and protect the people, the pipelines, and our environment. I appreciate the opportunity to spend a few minutes with you this morning. I wish the best to all of you and for a successful conference. Thank you.